6:44, happening today, the CEO of Mylan, the company responsible for the high cost of EpiPens, is testifying in front of lawmakers. In the last decade, the cost of the life-saving device has spiked from $100 to $600. It has people across the country accusing the company of price gouging. Well, now the company offers a $300 coupon to some patients, but it has not lowered the overall cost of the product. NBC2's Gabrielle Shirley is live outside of Health Park Medical Center in Lee County. Gabby, what should we expect from the testimony today? Will patients see a change in the cost of the pen?
Clay, that is the $1 million question. The price of the EpiPen has been decreased for some who can use that $300 coupon from the manufacturing company that you just mentioned. But as far as the future of this, the price, that's still too soon to tell, but what I can tell you is what the CEO of Mylan is expected to say to lawmakers later today. According to initial reports, the CEO says that the sale of one pack of two EpiPens, which costs about $600, only generates a $50 profit for the company. We spoke to a local pharmacist, and he's questioning that statement. He says that the drug found inside the EpiPen, epinephrine, costs only about a dollar. And to produce two EpiPens, that costs only about $20, leading people across the country and here in Southwest Florida to feel that the company is taking advantage of them.
I just think, you know, we're getting away from why medicine's important.
God forbid something happens. What do?
We spend about probably like $2,000 a year in EpiPens, sometimes more.
For people that are unfamiliar with this EpiPen, you may be thinking, well, if this is expensive, why not just use a different brand, a different alternative? Well, the truth is there are not many other options, and the options that do exist, they're less well known and therefore less trusted. I polled a majority of parents here in Southwest Florida, and they tell me that when it comes to their child, they don't want to take that risk. You can count on us to continue to follow this developing story throughout the day, and we'll be sure to keep you updated. I'm live here in Lee County, Gabrielle Shirley, NBC2.